Whether you're new to PPG's waterborne paint lines or an experienced veteran, it's important to follow PPG's best practices for care and application. In this video, we'll be going over the three main best practices for PPG's waterborne paint: equipment care, product use, and correct application. Let's go into a bit more detail about those now. The first waterborne best practice we'll be going over is equipment care. Ensure that your compressor and refrigerated dryer provides dry, clean air. You'll want to use a temperature and humidity gauge to ensure that there is less than 10% humidity in the line. You will also need to be aware of spray gun best practices. Be sure to check your DOX 440 guide to ensure that you're using the best practices for waterborne base coat for your specific brand of spray gun. As always, ensure your spray booth is clean. You should set aside some time for your shop to properly clean the booth. Replace any weak or broken lights, sweep thoroughly, and check the filters, replacing them if needed. You will also need the proper amount of airflow in the spray booth in order for your waterborne paint to dry properly. Be sure to check the airflow using an anemometer 1 inch away from the vehicle. 75 CFM is a good target to aim for here. Check the airflow of your booth in all four corners, as well as above the roof line, in the middle booth area, and along the sides of rocker panel areas. Know where your booth's dead spots are. The next best practice we'll be addressing is product use. Ensure that you're reducing the mixed base coat for 23 to 28 seconds in a number 4 DIN viscosity cup. For best performance, include 10% adjuster and 5% modifier in ready-to-spray base coat. The final best practice is correct application. Before you start spraying, ensure you've cleaned the surface of the intended spray area thoroughly using wax and grease removers. You should also be sure that there is no dirt passing through the screen. This helps keep flow and spray pattern dispersion even. Select the appropriate clear coat for the size of the job and apply the recommended G-shade in sealer or in base coat G-shade to achieve good color match. Be sure to wait 15 minutes between sealer and base coat at 70 degrees. Base coat application results are optimized when each coat is fully dehydrated. This can be achieved through the use of an air knife or air amplifier. Wait 15 minutes between final base coat and clear coat application. After that, you're ready to apply your clear coat. Congratulations! Now that you've brushed up on PPG's best practices for waterborne paint application, you're ready to spray. If you have questions, be sure to contact our customer service helpline. Keep an eye out for other videos in this series regarding waterborne paints.